Hi students, coming to the next topic, that is the type conversion. So the type conversion is also called as typecasting. So both are the same, the type conversion and the typecasting, both are the same. So what is a type conversion? So here by seeing the name, what do you understand? A type can be converted. So if you are using one data type, that data type of variable can be converted into another data type value. Okay, so let me write. A typecast is basically a conversion from one type to another. So a typecast is basically a conversion from one type to another. So there are two types of conversions. There are two types of conversions. So what are the two types of conversions? One is the implicit conversion. Let me write this. The type conversion is of two types. One is implicit conversion, implicit type conversion. And another is explicit type conversion. Type conversion. Okay. So the first thing is the typecast is basically a conversion from one type to another type. There are two types of type conversions. One is an implicit type conversion and another is an explicit type conversion. So let's see what does this implicit type conversion was. First, implicit type conversion. So what do you mean by this implicit type conversion? So implicit type conversion, if a compiler, let me write the point, if a compiler converts one data type into another type of data automatically. So this point you have to be remember that automatically is called implicit type conversion. So if a compiler converts one data type into another data type of a data automatically, then we call it as an implicit type conversion. So this implicit type conversion, there is no data loss. So the main advantage here is, while converting from one data type to another data type, there is no data loss. There is no data loss. Okay. So the example for this is, let me write the example. So the example is, let's take the short A is equal to 20. Okay, it's a data type short I am using. Now the implicit conversion I am doing. Int b is equal to a, which is an implicit conversion. Implicit conversion. So what's the hierarchy? So a is a short data type, but the short I assign to the integer. So you can assign the small value, the small range of value to the large range of value. So which is done automatically. So while you're performing this, there is no data loss. Okay, because A is having the range less than the B variable, because this is int and this is a short. Okay, so you can assign the boolean values to character, and you can convert the character types to the short int, and you can convert the short int to the integer, and even you can convert the integer data type to the long, and you can convert the long data type into the float, like that. Okay, so this everything, if you are converting from short smaller to the bigger, okay, so that can be done implicitly. So there is no force here. They can done automatically. That type of conversion you call it as an implicit type conversion. Now let's see the second one. What is the second one? Explicit type conversion. explicit type conversion. So what's this explicit type conversion is saying? Suppose when a data of one type, when data of one type is converted explicitly, is converted explicitly to another type, to another type with the help of predefined functions, with the help of predefined functions, okay, is called explicit type conversion. So what he is saying, when data of one type is converted explicitly to another type with the help of predefined functions, we call it as explicit. So here there is a chance of data loss. There may be a data loss in explicit conversion. There is a data loss. Why? Here in explicit data conversion, the data will be lost because the conversion is done forcefully. Okay, it's not done automatically, whereas in implicit conversion, the conversion will take place automatically. But in explicit type conversion, here we are forcefully converting the data type explicitly by using the predefined functions. So some functions cannot be made implicit, like some functions, some conversions cannot be made implicitly. What type of conversions cannot be made implicitly? Okay, so those are like into to short. You can't convert integer to short, because whenever you convert from integer to short, there is a data loss will be there, because the integer range is more than the short range. So while you are converting forcefully from integer to short, there is a loss of data will there is a chance of data loss. Okay, so this type of expressions you call it as a explicit type conversion. Okay, so the higher data, let me show you in the diagram. So let's take, this is the higher data type. I'm telling the explicit type conversion. So this is the higher data type. Okay, and here you are having the lower data type. Lower data type. So you are trying to convert the higher data type value to the lower data type value. So while you are running from higher to lower, so there may be a data loss. There is a chance of data loss. So this type of equation process, you call it as explicit type conversion. Explicit type conversion. Okay, so the higher data type to lower data type. So this is done forcefully. Okay, so these are the two different types of conversions. One is the implicit type conversion, and another is the explicit type conversion. Thank you.